Welcome everyone to our virtual Greatest Family Reunion, an alternative to our much loved Christmas Carol concert. I'm Meng Harrod and I'm your host for this evening. Mark, our Chief Executive, sends his very best wishes and his apologies for not donning his Christmas jumper and being with us here tonight. Unfortunately, the latest round of COVID restrictions has thrown just another challenge into our plans to bring you an alternative Christmas Carol concert this evening. I know how much many of you look forward to this evening, a chance to come together with familiar faces in the beautiful Holy Trinity Church. I know that for the last 3 years that I've been with Hope and Homes for Children, it's been the one work event of the year that I've most looked forward to, not least because I've got the chance to meet many of you, but because every year I come away knowing a little bit more about what makes Hope and Homes for Children so special. So here we are in our homes, coming together to celebrate families across the world who this Christmas will be together, thanks to your support. Families like Maxim's, whose story we'll share a little bit more about later this evening. And so on behalf of Mark and the whole team at Hope and Homes for Children, we hope you enjoy this evening of entertainment brought to you from across the country and indeed across the globe, with performances, stories and readings from a collection of staff, colleagues and supporters just like you. This night has always been an opportunity for us to say thank you. So thank you for joining us and thank you for all the support that you've given us this year where we've all had to dig so deep. Thanks to you, we've been able to mount an incredible response to the challenges that COVID has placed on us this year. You've helped keep children in education. You've ensured that we've been able to deliver much needed medicines and basic food parcels delivered by our teams of social workers on the ground to families locked in and unable to earn the vital income that they so depend on. You've helped us to keep families safe in their homes, often basic homes, with many of the necessities that you and I depend on, but homes where love and protection can thrive. And most of all, you've helped us do what we do at our very best, which is to bring children home from loveless orphanages into the protection and love of a family, where they belong, just like any child belongs. Your generosity, loyalty and commitment has been the saviour for many children and families this year, and it continues to be so. We launched our Christmas appeal, The Greatest Family Reunion, to help us raise vital funds to ensure that we can deliver on our commitments made to families and children in Moldova and Romania this year. And with your support, Maxim is now home with his dad, Alexandru. Their story represents just one of the stories that you've made possible, thanks to being with us every step of the way. And so what better way to start our evening than with a choral performance from Cantus Mundi National Programme, a programme of social integration that brings together children and young people through music across Romania. With 1,600 choirs and over 58,000 children and conductors, the programme tackles social integration through ethnicity, social status, and mental and physical ability. Our team in Romania have worked with the national programme for many years, and we're delighted to bring us our first performance, recorded pre-lockdown, by the Uliumenu Choir, singing Joy to the World.
Thank you.
Joy is something that we all need to look forward to this season, and what a beautiful way to remind us of that. Now to a firm favourite, legendary journalist and broadcaster and long-standing patron of Hope and Homes for Children, Kate Ady, who reads us a passage from the Gospel according to St Matthew, chapter 2, verse 1 to 12.
Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief scribes and priests of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, 'And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least amongst the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel.'" Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child, and when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also." When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way.
So from Dorchester, where Kate kindly filmed her reading, I'd like to take us now to Moldova, a former Soviet Republic state with the highest levels of poverty across Europe. Here, without the right support, many children face being taken from the arms of their parents and placed in loveless orphanages on the false belief that they will be better cared for. Here's Liliana Rotaru, our programme director on the ground, to share Maxim's story.
Good evening, everyone. I'm speaking to you from Chisinau, the capital city of Moldova, tonight, and I'm here to tell you about a little boy called Maxim. Maxim was born with cerebral palsy, a lifelong condition that affects muscle and movement. When he was a baby, his mom left, and his dad, Alexandru, fought poverty and prejudice to care for Maxim and his big sister, Mihaela, all by himself. But the authorities had no faith in a single father to care for a child with severe disabilities on his own. Without the extra support they needed, life was a daily struggle for Maxim's family. And so, 2 days before Christmas, when Maxim was just 3 years old, he was separated from his family and taken to an orphanage like this one. Maxim spent the next 3 years in the institution, the next 3 Christmases alone, without the family who loved him, without the Christmas presents, with no one to love and comfort him. We are working with authorities here in Moldova to close that orphanage by finding the right family-type alternatives for every child. But when we spoke about Maxim, the staff there said, "It's a hopeless case." However, my colleague Renata, a young, dedicated social worker, spoke with Alexandru, Maxim's dad, and we discovered a man who deeply loved and missed his child. But he was so angry at the way he had been treated and did not believe he would ever be allowed to care for his son at home again. So Renata worked closely with Maxim's dad to rebuild his trust in the authorities and work out a plan to make it possible for Maxim to come home to the people who loved him. This included helping Alexandru to repair and improve his home, and also, very importantly, lobbying for him to be registered as Maxim's official carer. This opened the door to the social payments and support he needed to be able to care for Maxim at home by himself. Tonight, I'm so happy to tell you that finally, Maxim is now safe at home with his family. He and Mihaela are getting ready to spend their first Christmas together as a family during the last 3 years.
Consider că pentru băieția acest Crăciun va fi unul deosebit, pentru că el nu va mai petrece în internat, ci va petrece în sine familie, acolo unde este cald, unde este iubire și unde este multă bucurie și, într-adevăr, orice sărbătoare își îndeplinește scopul de a fi tradițional.
From Maxim and his family, and also from all of us here, I want to thank you so much for all your support this year. We wish you a safe and happy Christmas with your own friends and family, as much as the rules allow. Thank you.
That's what we're here for, to give children the chance to grow up in the love and protection of a family. You've made that possible for Maxim this Christmas. Thank you. And now for something completely different, as we head over to Downton Primary School, where Year 5 came together in a COVID-safe way to record a poem for your enjoyment.
Dear Auntie, oh what a nice jumper. I've always adored powder blue, and fancy you thinking of orange and pink for the stripes. How clever of you.
Dear Uncle, the soap is terrific, so useful and such a kind thought. And how did you guess I just used the last of the soap that last Christmas bought?
Dear Gran, many thanks for the hankies. Now I really can't wait for the flu and the daisies embroidered in red round the O for Ollie. How thoughtful of you.
Dear Cousin, what socks! And the same sort you wear, so you must be the last word in style. And I'm certain that you're right that the luminous green will make me stand out a mile.
Dear sister, I quite understand your concern. It is a risk sending jam in the post, but I think I have pulled out all the big bits of glass, so it won't taste too sharp with spread and toast.
Dear Grandad, don't fret. I'm delighted. I don't think your gift will offend. I'm not at all hurt you gave up this year. You just sent me a fiver to spend.
What delightful, polite children. A huge thank you to Downton Primary School and all the children that got involved. Now would be a great time, if you haven't already, to drop us a line in the chat function. Just add your name and let us know what you think of tonight's performances. We're not done with the music yet. I'd like to introduce now Grace Lovelace, a mezzo-soprano, who's going to sing Ave Maria and Little Drummer Boy.
Thank you.
Wasn't that just amazing? A huge thank you to Grace. And now to two of my favourite people, and I'm sure yours too. COVID-19 couldn't keep our founders, Mark and Caroline, away from this year's virtual carol concert. And so here's their personal message of thanks to you this Christmas.
Well, hello everyone, and thank you so much for joining us here for this first and hopefully only virtual carol concert. It is wonderful. It would be wonderful if I could see you. But for us, this carol concert has been the most important event of the year. We started having them on the very first year, 25 years ago, when we had them in the Holy Trinity Church in Sloane Street. And after about 4 years of being there, the bishop wrote to us a few days later and said we had contravened health and safety regulations by having too many people in the church, and would we go elsewhere next year. And so it was then that we went to St. Mary Abbot's in Knightsbridge, and we have been there ever since. And this really has become our sort of pastoral home. Many of you have come every year, and I can visualize you now sitting, some of you sit in the same seats every year, and I can imagine you there, and I can see the Rotary Club of Royston, about 20 of you in the benches up there. And so it's wonderful that you should join us this evening. I really wish desperately that we could all be together, because for us it is the most important event for the year, because we get to meet you. And we can say personally, thank you for your support. And it's the only time in the year that we meet most of you. And it's very, very special. So we will miss it this year. And hopefully we will be able to go back and have another one next year. So put it in the diaries, the first Wednesday in December. We started Hope and Homes for Children 25 years ago with a very specific aim of providing homes for orphans of war or disaster. And of course, there can be no greater disaster than what is going on in the world today. And for some people like us, we're lucky, it is just inconvenient. But for others, it can be totally disastrous. And for the countries in which we're working, some of the poorest countries in the world, of course, they are suffering too. And the children in those countries, the poor children, the most vulnerable children, are those that don't have any families or any homes. And they have no voice. They can't shout out and say, help us. So we are their voice. And that is why our work has to continue. We cannot just say, well, we'll have a moratorium for a year and come back. They need us. They need us today. For them, every day in an institution is a day too long. They don't have a Christmas. They don't have a birthday. They have no days which are any better than any other days. They live in a world of grey misery and suffering without any hope, and certainly with no love. And I think there's no more succinct way of demonstrating this by this wonderful poem by Gabriella Mistral.
We are guilty of many faults and errors, but our worst is abandoning the children, neglecting the fountain of life. Many of the things we need can wait. A child cannot. Right now, his bones are being formed, his blood is being made. His senses are being developed. To him, we cannot answer tomorrow. His name is today.
I think that could well be the collect for Hope and Homes for Children. I'd like to pay tribute to Mark Waddington and all the Hope and Homes for Children staff, both here and abroad. They have worked incredibly hard through this extremely difficult time. They've been innovative and inventive and done things that we would never have thought of doing before, just to keep the momentum, keep their foot on the accelerator. And particularly, of course, it has been difficult for our overseas staff who have to work on the front line with the children. They are the real heroes because they're working in extremely distressing and difficult circumstances.
But you are the people who make our work possible. And we cannot thank you enough for your amazing commitment and support over many, many years, but particularly this year, where you have been so generous and we have needed your help so desperately. Without you, we could do nothing, and the children would have no hope of ever knowing that most precious thing, the love of a family. On their behalf, we thank you most sincerely and hope that you, like us, will be able to join with your family over this Christmas time. And we wish you a very, very happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
A huge thank you to Mark and Caroline. I know they'll be watching tonight and raising a glass to each and every one of you. As we draw the evening towards a close, we have a little bit more music. So back over to Downton Primary School for their rendition of Jingle Bells. Weren't they just adorable? As we come to the close of our evening, all that remains is for me to thank you. Thank you for bringing Maxim home to his dad, Alexandru, for keeping so many children safe in their families, for reuniting others, and for rebuilding families for the children that can't return to their own. Despite all the challenges that COVID has placed on us this year, we've been able to keep hearing children's voices and responding to their needs. 2021 is fast approaching and the job doesn't get any easier, but we are resolute. Until every child gets to grow up with the love and protection of a family, we will continue, and we'll continue to navigate these challenging times. With a huge thanks to all of our performers this evening and to everyone who went above and beyond to bring this virtual greatest family reunion to you this evening. Thank you. On behalf of everybody at Hope and Homes for Children, we wish you a peaceful Christmas and a happy, healthy New Year. To sing us out, I'm handing over to the Bluebells from our Vale of Pusley support group with their fabulous rendition of Away in a Manger. Good night. Oh.